Hey, hey, it's Tamara here. Welcome to another episode of my Devlog series about the development of a simulation game Lost in Athilidus. In case you're new to this channel, be sure to subscribe to see more game dev content like tutorials and devlogs. Also, I will be making a special announcement about this game next week, so turn the notifications on to be the first one to know. To recap, this is what I've done so far. We can build things, make goods and factories, and also craft things. This mechanic is still kinda raw, so I have to work a little bit more on it in the future. And let's see what we've got for this episode. In this video you will see the development of a new system in the game – quest system. This seemed easy at the beginning, but in the process I had to learn a new feature – custom editors. So you'll see me fight with it for the first time. And the last, but not least, the game will be finally getting some sound effects. Now grab some cold lemonade and continue watching this video. The first thing I started working on this week was a quest system. I think it is a must-have for a simulation game like this. It really helps to guide the player through the story. And it's also very engaging. Sometimes I found myself playing a game just to complete all these quests and get to the end. Like with any other system that I have never developed, I started with searching for some tutorials on YouTube. I found a simple one from Brackies, which gave me a good idea about what classes I need for this. But in the description there was a link to a different tutorial that was claimed to be more advanced. There was actually a series of videos, I followed through a couple of them, but there was a problem. Here's the thing with those videos. They were good, but they didn't use scriptable objects. Imagine a game where you have a lot of different quests. Creating a separate C# script for each of them is not an option. Another major thing that I didn't like was how the player got these quests. They were supposed to get them after talking to NPCs. In my game, the quests should follow each other, creating a complex storyline for the game. I decided to make my quests scriptable objects with the same properties that the tutorial suggested. But I ran into a problem. I had a base class for quest goals and child classes for all the types of goals, like a gathering goal or a building goal. I wanted to be able to add a new goal to a quest right in the inspector. I thought if it is possible in code to add different child classes to a list of base classes, then it must be possible in Unity too. Once I've come up with this question, I looked for a solution. I found an answer that said that I should create a custom inspector for my class. Wow, I've never done that before. That's great! I always like a good challenge. Actually, I used to think that writing scripts for Unity Editor was like a whole new level of programming. But if you have small requests for this feature, it's pretty easy. To create a custom inspector, you have to write an attribute about the class declaration that it is a custom editor and make the class inherit from editor. And there is a bunch of methods that you can use to create the look that you want. If you want to know more about this feature, I'd recommend checking out a tutorial that I left you in the description box. I tested this script that I found earlier and it kind of worked. I was able to add different goals to one list. Everything looked good, until I ran the game. The goals were disappearing from the list. I tried a couple of different approaches to make them visible, but nothing worked. This is because of the way that Unity serializes things. I won't go into detail, but I will tell you about my solution. I left the quests as scriptable objects, and also made goals scriptable objects as well. When I create a new quest, I have to create a separate instance of a quest goal and put it into the list. This way, even though I am putting a child class into a parent list, no data is lost and everything works. I put together a mock-up for the UI of the quest. I have a title, description, a placeholder for a character who possibly gave the player this quest. Yeah, I know I said no NPCs, but this is different. Quests come one after another, and you don't actually talk or meet the NPCs to get a quest. And we also have the quest goals, with description and requirements. I put together the very first quest in the game. It is possible that it is really going to be in the game. I say so because I was actually planning on adding real quests later on. These were just for testing. In this quest, you have to collect a few bricks to build more houses in your town. Now it is time to make it work, so the player can actually complete a quest. This was an easy part. I just subscribed goals to the appropriate events, like the collection of a product or a new house placement. The advantages of using an event manager is that different instances don't have to know about each other. A factory invokes an event, and every object that cares about this event performs an action. As I said before, the quests should line up one after another, so I implemented this functionality too. Next, I decided to make the UI look good. I was putting off this process because I didn't want to end up scrolling through different assets and not being able to stop because they are so beautiful and I want to use them all. But it turns out that I already had all the elements I needed for this window. It's better to keep the UI in one theme anyway. Another thing that I made this week was an audio system. In fact, I just used the code that I wrote a while ago, because it is totally reusable. And now, let's take a moment to listen to the audio that I found. I thought about using music for this game, and I probably will add some in the future, but the thing is, I didn't find something that would really fit in the game. So I'll just keep searching while you can enjoy these amazing nature sounds. A word of advice, if you plan on doing button clicks, it's better to write a simple script that inherits from button and plays a sound at the beginning of your development. I didn't do it, so I had to go through each button and replace the script with mine. I didn't add the same sound to all the buttons in the game. For some, I want to find a different one. In that case, I would just play the sound right where I perform some action on button click. And the last thing that I did was settings menu. It's just a simple window with sliders and buttons. However, I learned something very important about changing the volume in the game. It turns out that I have been doing it all wrong. In a nutshell, when the slider value is changed, I used to just assign the value to the audio mixer parameter. But the thing is that you shouldn't do that. The sound volume is logarithmic, whereas the slider value is linear. It causes the slider to be too sensitive. I learned it from a tutorial that I highly recommend to watch if you are doing it wrong too. Now, it is time for the finale. This is how the game looks now. Although it might seem like there is not much to look at, but I think this week was still quite successful. I made a fully functioning quest system, and even learned how to create a custom editor for a class. I will be definitely learning about it more, because it would make my dev life easier. And now the game has a lot more life in it. The sounds instantly make the game more appealing and alive. I will be looking for a music soundtrack for this game, but right now it already feels better. And this is it for this video. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to my channel to see more devlogs in the future. I'll see you next week. Bye!